In this illustration, we intend to simulate the seepage in the soil underneath a concrete dam in the Abaqus software. The concrete dam is composed of a row of sheet piles with an embedded length of 15 meters, and the sheet piles are placed in the heel of the dam, and you can observe that in the picture. The simulation is aimed at drawing the flow net, which can be observed in the picture. In the next picture, you can observe the equipotential lines, and in the next one, the flow lines can be seen. Actually, we are going to simulate the example 9-10 from Sam Helwani book in the Abaqus software. In this picture, the flow net which has been drawn in Sam Helwani book can also be observed. Here, you should first watch this film and after that observe training in continuation. I will enter the Abaqus software for simulation. So I'll open the file of the previous model to apply some changes on it. From here, I'll open the file of previous model. The first change that should be applied is creating geometric shape of the sheet piles. If we glance back to this book, it has been explained in Sam Helwani book about the sheet piles, saying that embedded length of the sheet piles is 15 meters, which can be observed in the picture. It has also been explained in continuation that the sheet pile has been placed in the heel of the concrete dam. Also, its geometric shape is in form of a narrow V-shaped gap. Now we'll return to the Abaqus software and create the geometric shape of the sheet pile. I'll click on Create Part Tools. Here I'll draw a vertical line and put the first length as 15 meters, that is the same as embedded length. According to the book, the sheet pile should be placed in the heel of a dam and is in form of a narrow V-shaped gap. Well, I will click on Offset Curves Tools, select this line, and then the quantity of 5 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 2 meters, that is equal to 5 centimeters. As you observe, this line has been put on the left side, so I'll click on Flip so that it would be translated to the right side and OK. In this manner, one line was created. I will offset this line once again and OK. So, 3 lines were drawn in this manner. I'll complete the shape from here. Actually, I intend to draw a V-shaped gap in this way. So I'll start from here, then come to this point. After that, to this point, and complete the shape like this. In the next step, I should remove the extra lines. To do so, I'll click on Auto Trim. Zoom in on the shape, remove this line, then omit this line. I'll also omit this extra middle line, and the final shape, as you observe, will be created in this manner, that is in form of a V-shaped gap or geometry of a V-like shape. As you observe here, the section or gap that is to be cut from our main model is actually a gap for our sheet pile. I'll click on Done in this manner. As you see, this void gap is actually our sheet pile. In the next step, I'll enter Load Module from the Load Manager menu. Click click on edit, then yes. Here we have specific weight of soil. I'll click on this arrow and select the geometry of soil. Here the boundary condition constrains the whole of the model, so I'll select the whole of that again. We intend to draw the equipotential lines in this question, so we must select suitable boundary condition for it. If we glance back at the shape in the book, we'll see that the pore pressure is equal to 117.7 kilopascal in this part and a zero in the downstream of the dam. Now, based on mentioned explanations, we'll translate this part where the pore pressure is 117.7 kilopascal to the upstream of the dam, and this part where the pore pressure is translated to this one, the quantity of which is zero, and that's okay. Here we have void ratio, so I should click on the arrow, select the soil, and okay. Well, we have now finished the job in the load module, so I'll enter mesh module. Here I'll click on part, then on mesh part, and yes, this is the manner of meshing. The meshing in this section is not much suitable. I'll click on assign mesh control, select the geometric shape of soil. From here, select chord free, OK. Here, put algorithm, medial axis, and OK. Mesh part, and yes. So the meshing is done in this manner. That is so exquisite and in good order. In the next one, I will enter job module and click on create job. As we had mentioned, we intend to draw equipotential lines in the first place. So here I will click on submit. We intend to draw equipotential lines for the soil under the concrete dam. Well, the analysis was done successfully. I click on results, then on plot contour. From here, put the output on the pore pressure. In this part, I remove the meshing from the model so that we can observe the results much better. From this section, I'll put contour type on the isosurface and apply that. I will put the quantity of as 24, apply, and OK. As you see, our equipotential lines are drawn in this manner. Now I'll return to the book so we can compare them with the results there. Here I'll magnify this. As you see, the picture we observe here from Sam Halveni book is the flow net. In this picture, the flow lines and equipotential lines have been drawn all together simultaneously in this manner. What we have drawn here are equipotential lines. Now, in the next step, we are going to draw the flow lines as well. I'll enter load module. First, I will select a proper name from the model copy in model menu. In this manner. Then I will translate the boundary condition of the pore pressure that is equal to 117.700 pascal to the bottom of the model and zero pore pressure to the underneath of the concrete dam as well as the sheet piles. Now I will zoom in on this surface and this one. I should also select this and OK. As you see, it should be like this, under the concrete dam, and in addition, the pore pressure under the sheet piles must be zero. In the next step, I'll enter the job module, click on create job. Then on submit and wait until the analysis is done completely. Once the analysis was completed successfully, I will then click on result on plot contour and from here select the pore pressure. I will put the quantity of contours equal to 13 from here and OK. Now if we put the results we gained here together with those we had gained for equipotential lines in the previous step, all in one picture, the flow net will be drawn.